Is AI going to replace us software engineers, or it's simply going to make us better at our jobs? Some think AI could outsmart us, changing our jobs forever. But looking at tools of today, Devin or Cody, they tell a different story. They're helpful, but they have got their limits. Hi there, I'm Sajal, software engineer with over a decade of experience at FAANG companies. And in today's video, I'll be diving deep into this debate. I'll explore the perceived threats of these changes, how far are we in this evolution, and the four insights every software engineer should arm themselves with in this era. So if you are navigating the waters of tech, thinking about the impact of AI on your career, you are in the right place. Let's get into it. So about 13 years ago in 2011, Marc Andreessen, who is Silicon Valley's greatest venture capitalist, said software is eating the world. His famous claim had a very important element, which was, why now? He said, there were 6 decades of computer revolution, 4 decades since the invention of microprocessor, and then 2 decades of the modern internet. So that it had all the components that were needed to revolutionize all industries through software. Now, listen to what Jensen, Huang of Nvidia had to say in 2024.
Everybody should learn how to program. And in fact, it's almost exactly the opposite. It is our job to create computing technology such that nobody has to program.
He has also said software is eating the world and AI is going to replace software. Wow, that means we're finally ready to replace software with AI. But that's not what it means. It means AI will be part of all software. And without AI, software is pretty much useless. He also boldly claimed that kids today don't need to learn coding, which is true, but they still need to learn how to build software. They can use AI in that software, but they still need to build software to solve real-world problems. So let's try to answer, is it here? So this week, the tech world buzzed with the revolution of Devin AI. It's stepping into the shoes of what software engineers do. Devin boasts a demo, where it tackles real-world coding problems from GitHub on its own. While it's not flawless, successfully handling only 13 to 14% of issues, the potential for AI was laid down. It was to encroach on software engineering territory like it has never been done before. Devin represents a leap towards automating an orchestration of tools which software engineers use on a daily basis, such as terminals, browsers, code, editors, and shifting human involvement to more abstract decision-making. But let's put things into perspective. Today's generative AI, while not miraculous, assists seasoned engineers by automating routine tasks. Recall the pre-era Google and the transformative power it had in the world of information at our disposal. Just as search engines revolutionized access to information, making complex domains more navigable and reducing exhausting manual reading, generative AI and language models offer a similar leap in efficiency and capability. They are like supercharged search engines. Andre Karpathy, who was the founder of OpenAI, also put out a great tweet. He made a parallel to our existing LLM capabilities for code to self-driving that is happening at Tesla. There are 4 parts to it. First, humans drive, and that brings data for the computers. Then second, AI helps with predefined tasks, keeping in the lane and distance from other vehicles. Third, AI takes on more complex tasks like changing lanes or looking at the red lights and stopping. Then we eventually get to the 4th level, which is AI is feature complete and we work on the long tail of quality improvements until full autonomy. It's similar. We are going to get there, but it's not there yet. We are on the trajectory, but we don't know whether full driving or full capabilities of LLMs will be there in 1 year, 5 years, or maybe 10 years. So AI will be part of every software. All software will be built using AI, but it's definitely not here yet. So knowing all of this, I have 4 insights every software engineer should think about. Number one, focus on your job and not your tasks. Andrew Ng, who has been a professor at Coursera, has been a pinnacle for AI education across the world, has really talked about not being afraid of AI taking up your jobs. You should think of it as AI taking up your tasks. It's like, instead of worrying AI will slash your whole pie, we realize it's just nibbling on the crust. He breaks it down super simple. Think of jobs as big baskets of tasks. Some of these tasks are ripe for AI to take on, but not the whole basket, or at least yet. It's a game changer because it allows us how AI can actually be the sidekick or a co-pilot in our lives, handling the mundane stuff so we can focus on the bigger picture or our job. So let me throw a real example. Helping out a teammate, I ran into a config which I hadn't seen before. Turned out, it was a Fox config from ChatGPT. It looked legit, but it was totally off. Here's the thing. You could have broken down the config into very specific tasks, which ChatGPT could have been correct at. But giving the entire job of generating a config by describing a business problem did not work yet. It will get there, but it's again not here yet. So, if your gig is cranking out code for a well-defined project, yeah, AI might be breathing down your neck. But the real essence of software engineering, in my mind, is strategizing, team wrangling, and big picture thinking. We have still got the upper hand there. It's a bit like AI's got the tools, but we are still calling the shots. Second, you have to level up. As you climb the software engineering ladder, things get fuzzier. When you are just starting out, you're handed tasks with everything spelled out, like following a recipe. That's the stuff AI is starting to munch on first. But as you grow, you're thrown into deep end with stuff like how to make our system more reliable, which is way more open-ended and definitely not within AI's playground yet. So even when you're thinking about your career ladder, it's really about how you can work on more ambiguous problems. So thinking about it, a junior developer today has got clear-cut tasks and it's all about execution. That's where AI is going to play a key role. But as you grow in your career and you become a mid-level engineer, your goal is not execution, but finding the right solution to a problem, which is not easy to do. And then as you grow to even a senior or a staff level engineer, you are into unknown territories. Actually have to define the problem or convert the business requirement into a problem, which is not what AI is going to do yet. You have to start thinking about how do you level up in your job and start working on more ambiguous problems. Third, learn prompt engineering. Software engineering is going through a bit of revolution, folks, and it's here to stay. Imagine a future where our main gig is kind of like being a director of high-tech orchestra, signaling when to swell and when to soften, but all plain English. We already have the tools like OpenAI's Codex, which by the way, is running circles around Devin. Within your spreadsheet, you can convert text to SQL. You just need to know how to get these LLMs work for you. There's going to be significant need of better and better prompts so you get these LLMs to work for your use cases. So here's a pro tip for riding this wave. Get cozy with prompt engineering. Mastering this could make you a wizard behind the curtain in this new automated world of coding. Fourth, there will be one engineer companies. You can start forgetting about joining big tech firms where you are automating the task which these big companies need to do. You can be the CEO of your own company. The real shift is actually becoming more like a CEO persona for your own operation. Your role as an engineer isn't disappearing, it's evolving. You'll oversee a range of functions using AI. For example, if you were leaning on your UX designer to build designs for your product, you can actually use Figma or Canva with these AI tools to build your own prototype. You can do a more cross-functional work as and when needed. So think of your role evolving to becoming a more CEO-like position or becoming a one-person army to do the entire software engineering. There is going to be a huge increase of these one-person companies. So here is my conclusion for this phase shift. The fear of being replaced by automation or by machines or by AI has been an old song throughout centuries. From the days of mechanical loom, there's always been a wave of worry that technology will make human labor obsolete. Yet, these predictions have never been true. The anticipated job apocalypse has never arrived. Instead, we have been seeing job growth and higher wages following these advancements. If I look at just the last 10 years from my personal experience, my fellow engineers in the US have always been worried of offshoring every innovation, like compilers or cloud computing, was supposed to cut jobs, but it did not happen. The narrative of building software without developers has been around since COBOL. So we really have to take a look at the demand rather than the supply. Currently, software or tech only contributes to 15% of the world's GDP. It is predicted by the World Bank that it will contribute to 30% by 2030. Where is this going to come from? So that clearly means we need more software. There is going to be an increase in demand as we go on. There's still only 20 to 30 million software developers in the world. We need more of them. With AI, the barrier to entry or the barrier to code reduces even further. This might mean we get 100 million more software developers, as now you can talk to software or to machines in plain English. All you need to do is learn prompt engineering rather than learning C++. It's kind of similar, where with Python, there were a lot more developers than when you had to use C or machine or assembly level language. You can think of this as productive benefits that will actually advance the world's GDP. The biggest difference, and I think this is the key point, is that this revolution is going to happen within a generation or within 10 years. No previous revolution has happened within a generation. It was always over a series of generations. So the one generation could actually just thrive with the skills they have learned, while the next generation learns another set of skills. This is not going to be true with AI. Here, you and I have to learn every week what is happening with AI. We have to learn these tools and we have to adapt to it. So overall, it's important to adapt and keep on learning at a rapid pace than resisting the change. So that was it. I hope you painted the broad picture of what is happening on software engineering with the advancement of AI. Let me know what you think. Let me know if you have different insights about this topic. Please share this video if you thought this was insightful and it will be useful for your friends to know. Also, please subscribe to this channel. We are adding more and more videos about helping you build a great career. So thank you. See you in the next one.